Today, we're going to review the Ancel X7 and go over some of its features, check my check engine lights in the Tahoe, and go over the ABS. Ancel was nice enough to send me the bi-directional OBD2 scanner. Hard plastic casing, which is nice. When we open up the case, we are first presented with the tablet itself, user's manual, the Bluetooth adapter, the charger for the unit. This does connect via Bluetooth, but if you don't want to connect via Bluetooth, we do have a hard wire that connects right here to the tablet itself with a USB. And this connects to the car. The unit came to me already charged, so that was very nice.
This is a bi-directional scanner, which means you can scan what's going on with the car, as well as input information into the ECU. Garage light off.
Okay, done.
First, I want to point out that it does have a pretty nice casing. It's all rubber. You could probably drop it and it'll be okay. Now, to turn on the unit, there's a button right here. Hold that. And it'll turn right on.
To unlock it, we just swipe up. You press this gear down here to get to all of its functions. You slide down here, press settings, press Wi-Fi network, connect to your Wi-Fi.
Let's go ahead and activate our unit. So press the update selection, press login.
Go ahead and activate your unit. Press activate. Confirm your unit. Activation is successful. Now I can log in. Since this is a Tahoe, it is a GM car, so let's go ahead and download the GM data. It's downloading right here. And we're good. Just press yes. Now we're set up for a GM vehicle. It also has Mercedes, Shangan, Ford, Land Rover, Mitsubishi, Opel, Mazda, Honda, Smart, Sprinter, Saab. You know, it keeps on going. The list goes on. First thing I want to do is connect to Wi-Fi, then slide to the right, go on settings, version update, and go ahead and update the tablet. As of recording this video, it's on version 12.2. I got the tablet at version 10. Now let's go ahead and connect the unit with this cord. In the Tahoe, the OBD2 port is right down here. Plugs in just like that. It already has power, and the Bluetooth is also turned on. It has automatically connected to my car. Let's quickly run through this front page here. So we have diagnostics. We can run diagnostics on the car. We can auto detect the VIN. Then we have hot functions, which goes over the most common functions that I guess mechanics use. We can go on quick support, which will take you to a team viewer, which you can connect to and have them help you with whatever you're dealing with. That's a really cool feature. DTC directory, which takes you to all these different fault codes and fault descriptions. You can send feedback and they will update the unit to your feedback if it's good feedback. And you got data playback. This is really cool. You can press play up here. It's now recording. Run a diagnostics, stop the recording. And then you can go back to data playback, video, and there you go. You now have a saved video of what you just did, which is really good to compare. Let's go ahead and turn the car over to accessory. Go to diagnostics, VIN, auto detect. This is Chevrolet, Tahoe. That looks right. We'll come back to system selection in a second. Let's do a quick test. Coming up with a lot more issues than I expected. Okay. So there's a large leak detected on my EVAP. But what I want to fix as soon as possible is my electric brake control module. So let's see what codes pop up here. So right rear wheel speed sensor circuit. It's saying that that's the circuit that's causing my ABS issue. And we will test that in a minute. Lost communication to your radio because I installed a new one. If you want to see how to install that, I have a link down below. We can go in system selection, engine control module, active test, go on fan relay. We can go ahead and run the fan relay. So that's pretty cool. You can easily detect whether that fan is bad or the bearing is going out. Super cool. So you can kind of go through all the fan relays and see which relay might end up being bad. EVAP solenoid will be right around here somewhere. We can press on. It's actually right back here, my mistake. If you hear the ticking noise, that means that relay is turning over, which is good.
And that is one of many things that this cheap OBD2 scanner just cannot do.
So I'm back on the diagnostics page. I ran out of the codes again. There could be a lot of residual codes popped up from when we swapped the engine and the Tahoe and turned it over whenever a lot of things were unplugged. So it could be a lot of these. It saves data from in the past as well. So I am going to wipe all this and see what pops up. Before I do that, go on electric brake control module, read codes. I do want to save this. I know that there is something going on with the ABS and this might be the cause of it. So I just took a screenshot of this page. I'll take a screenshot of this page. I know I have a large leak in the system, and this is probably something good to save too. I'm not gonna wipe everything. And it came back with 13 fuel pump control module issues. Probably the same thing that we just had. Pretty much, yep, same thing. And the only other one we have is this one right here. Low tire pressure system sensor not learned. Let's go on TPM, gonna press learn. Let's go ahead and do these in order. Left front tire pressure sensor. Is this doohickey here? Okay, well that one connected. Basically that function just starts the active learning process for the TPMS sensors. My front left one is an off brand. So I think that is an issue why it's not connecting, because after I installed that, I've always had issues with these TPMS sensors. And I know a TPMS sensor back there is out of battery. So I should probably replace them all with a good brand. Program key fobs if I want to, key fob button test. Now I want to test the ABS system. I am 95% sure it is a wheel speed sensor. And I replaced this wheel bearing, and that's when the issue popped up. I just want to figure out if all the wheels are spinning at the same speed, because if they're not, that ABS light will pop up. So go on system selection, electronic brake control module, live data. Let's do left front, right front, left rear, and right rear. Let's go on next. Okay. So as you can see, the right rear wheel speed sensor is displaying nothing here. So that there tells me exactly what's going on. Since I recorded it, I can then add it to this video, which is pretty sweet.
Before we go any further, I want to explain how to export footage. You could use this Bluetooth setting right up here and send it to another Bluetooth device, which I just could not figure out. Or you could do a share nearby option, which only works with another Android device. Connecting the bi-directional scanner to your computer with the charging cable is not very straightforward. So let me go ahead and explain it. So go ahead and plug the cable into the device and plug the USB into your computer.
Side down from the top of the screen, select the little gear or the little settings icon, select connected devices, USB, then change charge this device to transfer files. Now go to this PC, Ancel 2.0, select Android, data, then find the file that says X6, select files, user data, and finally screen record. Then finally you just have to drag it over and you have it on your computer now. Now, for some reason, it does not show the last recording that you did, so you need to record another one so the previous file can be shown in this file. It's weird, but that's how you gotta do it.
So hypothetically, is this wheel speed that's gone bad? The wire comes up and around, comes downtown, and the wire ultimately pops out, and the plug is right here. As I went to unplug this plug, I found out it's already unplugged. What the heck? The clip itself looks fine. I have no idea why it unplugged. Let's go ahead and plug that back in.
Got it all plugged in. Now let's see if these lights turn off. I had to reconnect it, I had to go back, then okay, it's connecting, communicating, and that should work now. So I unplugged and plugged in the battery and sprayed the sensor with some MAF cleaner. Maybe all the grime got around the connectors and doesn't have a proper connection. The lights are gone. There you go. There you go. Yes. I don't know why that makes me so happy. For some reason, I thought it was that front left. I don't ever remember unplugging that back right plug. And especially since the light turned on right after I replaced that wheel bearing. Okay, whatever.
I probably would have never figured out that was the issue if I did not get one of these. And I am so happy that I did. Finally, fix that annoying issue. If you want one of these bi-directional OBD2 scanners, then I have a link down below. You'll get 5% off on your purchase. And if you use that link, you'll be helping me out as well. I am very happy with this. Overall, this is a pretty awesome and versatile unit. I went through a lot of features, and there are so many more features throughout this unit if you want to get nitty and gritty with it. If I went through every little thing this unit can do, it would probably take me all day. One thing that really stood out to me was the fact that it will tell you all the small details from your history reports, what's actively happening, from where you can test relays on the spot. That is game changer for you and I. This is Chris AutoMotivate. Always appreciate me speaking to another. Thank you for watching the entire video, and I'll see you in the next video. Hey Siri, garage light off.
Okay, done.
And if you want to do that, I'll link that down below as well.